everyone, I'm Emily, and today we are talking about the science behind what happens when you put ivory soap in the microwave. All you need for this one is ivory soap and a microwave. First, let's talk about ivory soap. Ivory soap was first sold in the late 1800s, and it was marketed as the soap that floats. And if you've seen this experiment before, you've probably been told that the invention of floating soap was a happy accident. The story goes a little bit like this. There was a chemist who was responsible for churning the mixture of soap. They forgot to turn that churner off when they went to lunch, came back, and then were like, oh no, what do we do? Do we throw it out? Nothing was added to the mixture, it's probably fine. Then, later, they had customers writing in asking for the special floating soap. They had no idea what they were talking about because they didn't make any floating soap. Turns out they traced it back to the batch that those customers had bought from, realized that what had happened was when you churn it a little bit longer, you're adding these microscopic bubbles to the soap, making the final product less dense than water, and floating soap was all created by a happy accident. Well, I'm sorry to tell you this, but that story isn't true. There is a historian who is writing a book about the history of P&G, the company that owns Ivory Soap, and found that a chemist who is actually a son of one of the founders of P&G wrote in a notebook in 1863, I created floating soap today. Maybe we'll make all our stock this way. And then 15 years later, floating soap was on the shelves. So it wasn't a happy accident. It was actually quite intentional. But we can test this floating soap ourselves. Take your ivory soap and just toss it in some water. You can see that it floats right on top. Da-da-da! We can even push it down and it floats back up. It is less dense than water because of all of those air bubbles inside the mixture. Here is just a regular bar of soap. We can see that that sinks right down to the bottom just like so. Now let's see what happens when we put our ivory soap in the microwave.
Take your ivory soap, put it on a microwave safe plate, put it in the microwave, set your timer for 90 seconds, and watch the magic begin.
About what happened here. Look how pretty this is. It also smells so good. So we talked about how ivory soap floats because it has all of those little bubbles throughout the bar. That's what makes it really light and airy and less dense than water. Well, what happens when air heats up? That air becomes really energetic and it wants to expand the space that it's in. Well, because we have all of those air pockets throughout our soap, each one of them is trying to expand the space that it's in. The other thing that's happening is that soap is becoming warmer and a bit more pliable. So the air pockets are expanding and it's taking that soap with it. And our result is this beautiful, fluffy, whipped, wavy style soap that we have right here. And because each of those air pockets have become bigger, what we've done is made our already light and airy and less dense than water soap even more light and airy. And we can test this by just pulling off a piece here, and let's make it small so it'll fit in the same container, and see what it does when we put it on top of the water. We can see that our microwave soap floats even higher than our bar of soap in the water. So what we've done is by microwaving our soap, we've expanded those bubbles and reduced that density of our bar of soap even more. And that is the science behind ivory soap.
We can also microwave our regular bar of soap.
Turns out if you microwave a regular bar of soap, you also get a very similar effect, just maybe not as large because there are likely fewer air pockets in regular bars of soap, but every bar of soap is likely to have some air pockets, so you're probably gonna get the same effect.